You know these dating services on the internet? Find the person that's compatible to you. Okay? That's kind of scary. Find the person that's compatible to you. Okay. It's not of God. It's not of God. You say, why? Because God usually doesn't do that. I mean, I guess He can, but it's very rare. I want to marry a woman who just loves all the stuff I love. You may want to marry a woman who loves all the stuff you love so that she'll do everything you want to do, you selfish person. God, for the most part, is going to give you a wife or give you a husband that is not compatible to you. And you go, oh man, then maybe I was supposed to marry him. But see, the world tells you just the opposite, don't they? They tell you just the opposite. Why? Because everything the world's going to tell you is selfish and self-centered. They tell you just the opposite. Now, here's the way it's going to be. God will give you a mate who is strong in all the areas where they must be strong so that you are not tempted beyond what you can bear. But God is going to give you a husband, a wife, who does not meet your expectations in many of the areas where you most want him or her to meet your expectations. Why? Because he hates you? Why is he doing this? Well, first of all, many of your expectations are probably carnal and self-centered. But the most important reason is this. When you think about Jesus, what do you think about? Do you think about his wrath, his judgment? I don't. I mean, that's there. But when I think about Jesus, someone said, describe for me Jesus. What are the first words that pop into your mind with regard to Jesus? It would be unconditional love, grace, and mercy. Okay? Now, you know all those prayers that you make? Lord, I want to be like Jesus. Lord, I want to be conformed to the image of Christ. Okay. God's going to give you a mate who does not meet all the conditions. Why? Because if you're married to a man or a woman who meets all the conditions, you will never learn how to love unconditionally. Do you see that? You see, in marriage, you've got to ask yourself one question, and it's the same question you've got to ask yourself in everything. Do you really want what God wants? And most people, and some of the times, I don't. See, God wants your conformity to the image of Christ. You want a storybook marriage. You want a Hollywood marriage. At least the one on screen, not in the one on real life. God wants you to become conformed to the image of Christ. So He will oftentimes give you a mate who does not meet all the conditions and many times the most important conditions to you, so that you learn to love a person who doesn't meet the conditions. You learn to practice grace, favor unmerited poured out on this person. Do you see? Do you really want to be like Jesus? This is what marriage is about. And that's what makes it so wonderful, so real, and makes it so strong. See, most of the people in Denmark, they come together and they go, man, this person's not what I thought, and they're not compatible to me. We need to go out and find our soulmates. What they're saying is, this person didn't meet my self-centered, selfish desires. I'm going to go find somebody who can. Christianity enters into this relationship with this person. And when things are wonderful, and marriage can be wonderful, and there are times it's wonderful, you say, wow, this is great. But in those times of conflict, you're not shaken. You're not thinking that you made the mistake of marrying the wrong person. None of that. You know that this is the purpose. These little conflicts, these things going on, so that you will learn not to conform your wife to your own image, but you will learn to love her. You will learn to love him. And here's the thing. You can try all day long to make your wife like you, or you can try to make your husband like you, and it's not going to work. What you've both got to do is set your sights on becoming like Christ. It's like spokes on a bicycle wheel. Those spokes never touch. But as this spoke is headed toward the axle, and this spoke is headed toward the axle, they both come together. As my wife and I are two very, very different people. Very different. But as she is headed toward Christ, conformity to Christ, and I'm headed toward conformity to Christ, we come together. And the differences in our lives have been used by God to show me how unlike Christ I truly am. I'll give you an example. This embarrasses me to tell you, but I'm going to tell you. When I got married, I thought my wife and I would be a Batman and Robin team. You know, tag team wrestling, going out there, witnessing in the streets and all kinds of stuff. My wife, when she opens the Bible, it's amazing. I mean, the woman, you know, can just look at a passage and just start saying all kinds of wise things. She can write and all kinds of things. And I was just, but she wouldn't. And I would be like, look, you're just so gifted. You're wasting your life. Why don't you do this? Why don't you do that? And I'd get so frustrated. And one day she broke down crying in front of me. And she said, I just want to be your wife. See, I was trying to make her in my image. She said, I just want to be your wife.